All right, and welcome back to Lesson 3, Level 3, Part 4. In this statistical video, we're going to show you how to use Excel to calculate the percentiles, the quartiles, and introduce you to the analysis tool pack. So first off, what is a percentile? The percentile rank of a number is the percentage of numbers in its frequency distribution that are equal to or lower than it. For instance, a test score that's greater than 75% of the scores of people taking the test is said to be in the 75th percentile, or the 75th percentile rank, where 75 is the percentile rank. So using the same data that we used in the last video, where we have a date somewhere in 2018, the number of sales of a particular item on that date, and the day of the week, we're mostly going to be concerning ourselves with these two columns here. Let's find the percentiles of all these scores. So first off, I need some percents down here. So I could start here and put a 0 and then a 0.01 here. Let's see, let's convert those to percentages. Come up here to home, change it to percent. And now I want to drag that down to 100. So as long as I have two things highlighted, Excel will be able to pick up the pattern, and I can drag this down to 100. Oops, went too far. Double click on it to make that 100 come through. All right, so we now have a range of numbers from 0 to 1 in percentages. Let's look at a couple different ways to use the percentile functions in Excel. So the first one we're going to look at is the percentile that includes 0 and 100%. Equals percentile INC returns the kth percentile values in a range where K is in the range of 0 to 1 inclusive. So inclusive means we get to include 0 and 100. The array is this array of numbers over here. And if you remember from the last video, I named that range of numbers sales 2018. Comma K, and the K is the percentile number. So for that, I just click in this cell here, close my parentheses, and there we go. So if I want to copy this all the way down, because I've got these properly referenced, I can just double click on the fill handle here, double click, and it goes down. And I'm betting that if I get down to the 100th percentile, I've got 150. So what do these numbers mean? If I sold 26, that means that that quantity of sales was equal to or greater than 10% of all the scores in the sales 2018 data set. If I sold 35, then that number is better than or equal to 21% of the other sales numbers. 25th percentile is also called the first quartile. We'll talk about that in a minute. The number is 39. The 50th percentile is 71. That's also known as the median of the group or the middle value of the group, etc., etc., on down to 100, which is the maximum value of the data set. So let's take a look at the percentile that excludes 0 and 100, because we found that 0 is just the minimum value and 100 is the maximum value. So if we don't want either of those, there is another type of percentile function, equals percentile exe, where k is the value in the range 0 to 1 exclusive, so it excludes those. And I'm going to, for the array, that's our sales 2018 data, comma, this 0. And I'm betting that that returns an error, because this percentile excluding formula is supposed to exclude 0 and 1, so it's probably going to throw an error when we feed a 0 into it, and it does. But I can double click on this, and I now have the data set that excludes the highest and lowest number of the data set. Median's still the same. 25th percentile, or the first quartile, is the same. 75th percentile is the same. You'll have a few slightly different numbers because we excluded the high and the low numbers, but it depends on what you're looking for. You'll learn more about that in your statistics course in the future. All right, let's talk about the quartiles. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 equals quartile, inclusive, and exclusive. So inclusive, feed in our array, sales, comma, and here are the five different values that you can put in here. Minimum, first, second, third, and the maximum. So there's five different choices there. Hey, those just happen to correspond to those five different numbers there. So I'm going to click on that for the K, copy that down. So that's the minimum value, copy it down. There's the maximum value, there's the median, there's the first quartile, and the third quartile. Now let's do the same thing with the quartile exclusive, which excludes our zero and fourth quartile, or the min and the max. So equals quartile exclusive. The array is still the sales, and the quartile has to be either one, two, or three. So I'm going to click on this for the quartile value, and it throws an error because it's not an allowed number. But I drag it down, and then I get the same numbers here. So this is the percentile calculations. Here's the quartile calculations. Now there's a lot more to statistics, and you're going to learn more about that in your statistics course. That isn't the plan for this course, but I just wanted to introduce you to some of the basics. I also want to show you one thing that you're going to need in this class, but you're really going to learn more about it in subsequent classes after this if you choose to go that route. This functionality that's included in Excel is called the Analysis Toolpack. If you go out here to the Data ribbon, out under the Analyze portion of the ribbon, right now you just see Solver. Well, that's a Module 9 thing. There's no Analysis Toolpack here, so we have to enable it. Excel has the ability to add all kinds of functionality into its native application, but they don't always get loaded right when you first load it. So you have to enable these add-ins in order to get them to work. So come up here to the File tab, click on Options, and right here is Add-ins. So here's a bunch of add-ins that are already loaded into Excel, and there's hundreds, if not thousands, of other add-ins that are created by third-party companies that can add all kinds of cool functionality into Excel. But these are the ones that come natively when you load Excel. So Manage Excel Add-ins, go. And right here is the Analysis Toolpack. That's what you're going to need to do for this course. Hit OK. And now up here on your data ribbon, under the Analyze section, is the Data Analysis Tool. Click on that, and here are all kinds of cool different analysis tools that are built into it. I'm going to show you just a couple. We're going to do the descriptive statistics here first. So hit OK. In my input range, I'm going to type in sales 2018, tab, output range. I'm going to click on a cell over here that's empty. Or I can put it in a new workbook, show the summary statistics, show the confidence level. No, I don't want to do that. Maybe I want to show the largest number and the smallest number as well, or I could put the second largest or the second smallest or anything like that. Notice when I start clicking through here, it goes and finds the cell range for that sales 2018 range of cells. Hit OK. And here I get a whole bunch of cool stuff. Widen that out. Here's the mean, standard error, the median, the mode, the standard deviation, variance, kurtosis, skewness, range, minimum, maximum, sum, count, the largest number, the smallest number. So all that is built in automatically. You could calculate each one of these separately using Excel formulas, but that's one of the beauties of this data analysis toolpack item. It does it all for you in one fell swoop. All right, one other thing I'd like to show you in this data analysis toolpack is the ability to make a histogram out of all this sales data. For our next portion, I'm going to need some bins or buckets to compare to. So in the last video, I had a column with bins in it. So I'm just going to create a new data range here and put in 10, 20, etc. I now know that my maximum's 150. So I'll drag down to 160 just for the heck of it. And I'm going to name that range of cells something. Sales bins. Now if I go up to my data analysis, histogram, okay, my input range was my sales 2018, and my bin range was called sales bins. My output range is just a cell that I want. So I'm just going to click on, this cell looks fine. If I wanted a cumulative percentage and a chart output, I can click on those as well. And I hit OK. Make everything wide enough. And here's my output of my histogram. So here's the bins. Here's the frequency of or how many different items are in that bin. So if you're between 10 and 20, there's 24 of those. If you're between 20 and 30, there's 38 of those. And then the cumulative percentage of how much those add up is over here on the end. So notice there's none out here in the 160, and there's none more than 160 either. So 150 is the top of our range. So when you get to 150, you've reached all 100% of the samples. There's a cool chart that you can use as well. So that is all for this module. See you in the funny papers, and go Noles!